You know, oxygenated products are very, very important to the carpet cleaning industry. So when I sought out to make a product, I called mine Pure O2 Powder. And basically, it's an oxidizer brightener that attacks urine and other organic soils. And I feel like it's the highest quality and the highest percentage within inside of the industry. And I took it actually one step further. How so? Well, that's kind of what makes it unique, and we'll talk about it in a second. But first of all, it has no fillers. So the advantage of that is you don't have to worry about resoiling or attracting soil, okay? And on top of it, it mixes really, really nice. It has a very long shelf life, probably a longer shelf life than most of the other competing products on the market. And it actually brightens carpets naturally. So I like that a lot, especially light color carpets or carpets that have organic soiling or urine or something like that. It can really give it that nice pop. Now, to take it a step further, what we did is we went ahead and we added our citrus solvent into it. And we added just the exact right amount. So that way you don't have to worry about your employees taking your citrus solvent and just glug, glug, glug right into the inline sprayer. And so now it's blended just perfectly for you. It has just the right amount of citrus to the oxygenating product. So that way you maximize your results. It helps you get those body oils, the dead skin and stuff like that out of carpets, and really makes a difference and really gives you that solid, powerful boost. Okay, what about mixing it? Remember, the mixing instructions are on the container. Okay, but let's review it just for a second. There's three ways to use this, and you really have to pay attention and follow this carefully. It's very important. Number one is you can add it to your inline sprayer. And generally, you're just going to use one scoop, which is 2 ounces, and add it into your inline sprayer right along with your favorite pre-spray. Number two is you have an electric sprayer. I prefer a 2-gallon electric sprayer tank with a little bit of an open top, and I'll talk about that later and why. And you're going to use 3 scoops, which is 6 ounces per gallon. So if you've got 2 gallons in there, you're going to have about 6 scoops in there. And lastly, I like using a bucket. A bucket's really good when it comes to urine, and we'll talk about that in a minute too. But what I like is go ahead and per each gallon, I'll add 3 scoops. And I generally like to mix up maybe 2 or 3 gallons at a time in a 5-gallon bucket. And there's a reason for that. I'm going to explain that to you here in the tips and the tricks. And the number one thing is always mix it in an open container. And if you've got a bucket, just pop the top off. If you've got an open container, go ahead and use as hot as water as possible. You know, the hotter the better, because it'll activate the product. And what's going to happen is it's going to put off oxygen. That gas is going to off-gas, and it's going to bubble up on you. And if you put that immediately right into your inline, it's going to come through your weep hole, and it's going to be going everywhere while you're trying to pre-spray. You might get it on floors and everything. It's just not going to stop. So take the time and pre-mix it first, and never, absolutely never put it into a pump-up sprayer. I'll tell you why. When I first started cleaning carpets maybe 30, 35 years ago, I remember I mixed it up inside of a sprayer because I wanted to get a little pop on some Berber. So I went in there and sprayed that first, and I was going to spray my pre-spray down. And I went ahead and I put that container out on the front porch. And when I went back in there and started cleaning, I heard this large pop sound. Couldn't figure out what it was. I walked outside, the cap was missing. Guess where the cap was to the pump-up sprayer? In the neighbor's yard. Imagine if that was in the house, the damage could have done. Or if you're standing beside it, the damage that it could do. So make sure you always mix it in an open container. Now, when it comes to using it for urine, there's a cool little trick right here. Take your cap and drill a large hole for filling. And then the other smaller holes right here you can use for pouring it right onto the carpet. And that's what you basically want to do. You want to take and mix this product up, and you want to saturate that urine stain. And remember, the urine stain is usually double the size of what you see on the top. It's kind of like an iceberg. There's more down below than there is up top. So go ahead and totally saturate that urine stain when you find it with your UV light. And as a general rule, I find 1 gallon per 5 foot is probably ideal. Okay? And you also want to make sure you have like a 30-minute dwell time. It's very important. So take that 30 minutes, let it sit there while you're doing some work, and let the product go ahead and do its job. So you can go out to your truck, get all your equipment, come back in there, and then you can extract it. I like to actually kind of leave it just a little bit squishy. There's nothing wrong with that. And then I know I'm at the right point. But you don't want it so wet where it can wet your underlayment or your hard surfaces. I prefer to do it over concrete instead of hardwood floors. Or if you're working upstairs, make sure you don't overdo it, because you could do some damage and have secondary damage that you definitely don't want. Now, after you've let it set for that 30 minutes and you've got all set up, I like to take a subsurface tool like this right here, and I prefer one that rinses where I can hook it to my solution and I can go ahead and I can flush it out. So what's basically happening is I'm letting the fresh water or my rinse come through there and it's flushing the urine right through the subsurface tool. And once it runs clear, then I'll just move on to the next area and knock it out. Also, when it comes to walls, make sure you take a little bit of tape or maybe some tape and drape and drape up the walls so you don't get it on the wall so it doesn't leave any unsightly marks or hurt the paint or something of that nature. So remember, last but not least, remember that danger, always mix it in an open container. Hey, I want to take a quick second and thank everyone for their support of Truck Mount Forums. Don't forget, if you could go to our YouTube channel and subscribe, we'd really appreciate it. We're a father and son team that started Truck Mount Forums many years ago. So at truckmountforums.com, it's a huge resource where you can take in all types of information, research just about any subject, and take your business to the next level. Also, we have tmfacademy.com, which is an online resource and training school where you can learn all different types of diverse services to make your business more profitable. And if you need any products or any type of equipment and stuff like that, and the products that we've shown in the videos, just go to tmfshop.net. Lastly, if you need some information, you need it really fast, go to our Facebook group, Truck Mount Forums Professionals, and we'll help you there. Well, I'm Rob Allen. Have yourself a great day.